give you an example. Now, suppose a patient comes in and says, look, you know, I got this new job, and, you know, I think I'm doing really a good job, I think I'm doing superbly, but my boss, he just doesn't appreciate me. He never says anything nice to me at all. Well, and then stops and seems somewhat hesitant, doesn't know how to proceed. If one were to ask in some way something about that silence, you might find, in fact, you likely will find, very important key paths, key ideational roots that go back to early relationships in life and very often to the relationship that the patient has with you in the room. For instance, the patient might hear his boss being unappreciative in the same way that he always thought his father never gave him credit for anything. He might think that I, too, think that he's just being a silly namby-pamby complaining about something, and that I, too, as his abusive, censorious father, don't think that he has much to say about it. He might, in fact, be actually in a roundabout way telling me that he already doesn't like me and doesn't feel that he appreciates my work very much. Or he might even be able to be aware later on, probably in the analysis, that, you know, he has a touch of the same thing and that there are people that he doesn't really give much appreciation to, like his girlfriend or his best friend or even his parents.